everyone. I'm Lori Bernard Lowe, your Carroll County Out of the Darkness Experience Chair. I know you'd all rather be at Crim Gold today, as I would, together, to walk, to fight suicide together. Times are different, we can't do that, and we have to keep everyone safe. So I hope today you'll take the time, you'll go out with your friends, your family, and you'll honor and remember, and you walk, bike, hike, read a book, do yoga, do whatever you can to bring awareness and prevention of suicide and to honor your loved one. This has been a great year for me personally. I have joined the Carroll County Suicide Coalition, and we are happy to bring AFSP training to the Carroll County area this year. It's been great. The support and everything from the community this year has just been amazing, even with all of the other struggles that are going around. We appreciate all of your support for standing by us through all of this year, and for your continuing effort to help us in fighting suicide. And without you as a community and as a group, we could not do this. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. Take the time today to remember, to love, reflect, and cherish the memories that you have. Hug the ones you love a little tighter. The ones that struggle, be there for them. Ask if you're okay. And just remember, you're never alone, and Carroll County is in this fight together. So thank you guys always, always, always for your support.
I wear orange for the loss of a sibling.
The white is for the loss of our child.
Green is for a personal struggle.
Purple is for losing a relative or friend.
We wear honor beads at the Out of the Darkness walks as a way to pay tribute to a loved one lost, a personal struggle, or a victory.
They come in different colors that represent the many ways that we're all connected to the cause of suicide prevention.
Since suicide so often is hidden and kept in the dark,
the honor beads are really special because it's your way to be very open about your loss.
Gold is for losing a parent.
Silver represents the loss of a veteran or a first responder.
Red for losing a spouse or partner.
And teal represents having friends or family that struggle.
When I see other people with the same colored beads as me, it gives me hope that there's a future for all of us.
It's fantastic being here with these people who feel how I feel.
I wear orange, teal, and purple beads.
I wear green and teal beads.
I wear silver and teal beads.
And we all wear blue beads to show we support the cause.
Find your connection at afsp.org/honorbeads.
Hi everyone, Christine Moutier, Chief Medical Officer at the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. It's really my pleasure to take this opportunity to thank you for being involved and participating in the Out of the Darkness experience. Even though we can't be together in person, we can come together to raise awareness about suicide and suicide prevention and to support each other and the mission at AFSP. Thank you to our hardworking volunteers and staff for supporting the Out of the Darkness experience. Without their tireless efforts, we could not continue the life-saving work in suicide prevention that we do at AFSP. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about what has been going on at AFSP related to our work and the mission. This past year, we have funded 38 new suicide prevention research studies. And that brings our total current investment to $20 million, funding 100 ongoing current research studies in suicide prevention, making us the largest private funder of suicide prevention research. Through our 30,000 plus voluntary field advocates, we are leading the way in mental health and suicide prevention advocacy at the federal and state level, with over 50 state laws and 13 major federal policies being enacted into legislation just in the last several years alone. And most recently, AFSP has played a role in leading the establishment of the 988 three-digit number for people in crisis. We are truly a grassroots meets science organization with a long-standing dedication to those who have lost loved ones to suicide and now people with lived experience as well. But on the Saturday before Thanksgiving each year, many of you know that AFSP supports hundreds of large and small International Survivors of Suicide Loss Day events. And in 2019, there were 417 of those events in 26 countries around the world. And this November, we hope to see the same, even through virtual means of coming together. We are also working at AFSP in collaboration with the media and entertainment industry to shine a light on hopefulness in mental health and ways that we can support people who are struggling long before a suicidal crisis is reached. So by working with these content creators, we can make sure that stories that are being developed now for media and entertainment are drawing on the best research in terms of the difference that family members, mental health professionals, teachers, counselors, that we can all make, and that hope and resilience are in fact possible, and not only possible, but that we can make a difference in that way for suicide prevention. So none of that would be possible without your support. And we thank you again for joining in the Out of the Darkness experience, joining with us to prevent suicide. With all of us working together, we can and we will prevent suicide. Thank you so much.
Good morning. This is Commissioner Ed Rothstein once again doing a podcast from my beautiful home in Eldersburg. One of these days, I will get back to the recording studio up in Westminster. But until all of this challenges go away, we're going to continue to be responsible, safe, and healthy. And I'm going to be doing this, and I have a really special guest to interview in just a few minutes. But what I'd like to do is share what's on my mind up front. The first is the pandemic itself. We are now into virtual learning for our kids in the public schools. We're continuing to promote the wearing of masks and social distancing to keep ourselves as safe and healthy as possible. I truly believe, and you've heard me say over and over again, that life is good. And I really believe that life will continue to be good and get better as we work together. The second thing I'd like to share is, most recently, last week was 9/11. And we can all think about where we were during 9/11. You know, wearing the uniform for 30 plus years for myself, a lot of folks have shared with me, especially since that horrific date, that they thank me for the service that I've provided. What I often do is turn around and thank them for giving me the reason to wear that uniform, because we live in such a cool country, because we have a great culture and a great attitude in promoting democracy and doing what is right. Is it perfect? Absolutely not. Are we doing the best we can? I believe so. And I think since 9/11, when we were on bended knee, we didn't stay there for very long. We wiped off the dust and mud off of ourselves and continue to move forward in promoting democracy. It means a lot to me, as I believe it should mean a lot to you and your families. What I'd really like to do for the next 8 or 9 minutes is share with you something also that's on my mind, but often very challenging to talk about. And that has to do with suicide. And this, I believe, this month is Suicide Prevention Month. As I'm hanging up my phone, my daughter from England calling me, but that's okay. And it's Suicide Prevention Month. And most recently, there was an event held in Carroll County, which was one of, I believe, 10 events across Maryland called Out of the Darkness Experience. The special guest that I have with me today is Lori Bernard Lowe, who is, I believe, one of the co-founders of this event. So Lori,
yes, my husband. Hi, my husband and I started it 5 years ago in Carroll County.
You did. So can I ask, why did you start it 5 years ago?
It will be 6 years in January that we lost my stepson, my husband's son, to suicide. And we participated in our first walk about 9 months after that. And we were like, wow, Carroll County needs this. This is because his wasn't the first suicide that we had heard of, especially in a school. So we were like, we got to do it. So we both got trained, became volunteers with the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention, and we started it.
And what I want to do is, I do want to get a little bit personal to understand what's going on in your mind and in your heart as we're moving forward, but then also look at this objectively. Over the years in Carroll County, we have anywhere from 25 to 30 in that range of suicides a year in Carroll County. When I commanded Fort Meade, there were 6 suicides, and it ripped my heart every time there was one. And it was for all different reasons. But what I realized was that there was a potential for outreach in preventing suicide from happening, from minimizing some of the challenges that folks are going through. The challenge was to identify it. And the challenge was to work together and take away some of the stigmas. Now, with your personal experience with your stepson, can you tell me a little bit about him? What was his name?
Chase.
Chase. So tell me a little bit about Chase.
I'm going to try not to cry. He was amazing. He was only 12, which makes it even more heartbreaking because we didn't have any signs. Literally everything. He was happy-go-lucky. He was loving. He was caring. He was creative, inventive. You know, we had no clue that it was even in his mind. You know, he had seen a therapist. We had had him in therapy because he was also on the spectrum.
Right.
He had been diagnosed Asperger's at age 3, I believe. And so he was in, you know, middle school's rough. Middle school's a hard age. So we, you know, recognize that. And he was in therapy, but even his therapist was floored. We had no signs. He just did it, unfortunately.
So it's been 5 years. What were some of the things that you've learned on how to handle, you know, one, the grief that you're going through, but then also to share your story with others?
Losing someone to suicide is traumatic, obviously, but no one really knows the pain you feel until you have that, because you do. You have the whys. Why didn't I see it? Why didn't I help? Why couldn't I do this? Why didn't he come to me? And what I've learned is you can't. All you can do are look for some of the signs and ask people. My biggest thing now is be kind and ask someone, are you okay? You never know how a smile, a simple question, or just a look can change someone's entire outlook on their entire day. You don't know.
You know, that's pretty powerful. I end my emails and a lot of stuff I said it earlier with saying life is good because it is, and I really believe it. I've been in some challenging places across my career, and I'm always convinced that life is good. And I can't imagine what you're going to go through. I can only sympathize. I absolutely cannot empathize. With what you and your family is going through, what are some of your goals with this Out of Darkness project? I mean, you've been doing it for 5 years. So if you can tell me what a few of your goals are.
We just have, well, the AFSP is a great organization, and I have bought trainings to Carroll County. So I know the health department has done a few. We've had Winfield Fire Department do some. We've had a couple churches reach out, and the training's called Talk Saves Lives. And basically it is what to look for. What signs can you see? What can you do? How can you be there for someone who you think may be suicidal and struggling?
So what are some of those?
Changes in moods, depression, they sleep more, they don't talk, giving away prized possessions. There's, you know, changes in like habits, just different things they do. And then I think the main one is just quietness. Like you'll notice, or once they have a plan, it goes the opposite. They're happy. They went from low and dark to I'm happy, I'm go lucky, I'm this, I'm that, because they have an end in their mind, which is very sad. But that's how their mind, you know, when they're in a struggle such as that, that's, you know, they look for their way out.
The Out of Darkness event this year was different because of COVID-19. How did it go?
It was good. It was a lot of confusion of trying to figure out what, because, you know, we're used to meeting and walking. I mean, last year we had almost 900 people that showed up at Krim Gold Park and walked in Carroll County. way. So last year was amazing. We raised almost $100,000. This year, it took a long time to figure out what we were doing. So instead of a walk, we did a luminary ceremony. But I think we had about 75 cars come through, and we lit up Krimgold Park with luminaries. I don't know if you've ever been at Krimgold, but there's a huge hill, and we spelled out the word hope in luminaries, which was just beautiful. And we have gotten so much feedback of people saying how much they appreciated us taking the time to do something to honor their loved ones.
Raising so much money, why? Why do we need to raise funds here in Carroll County for suicide prevention?
So all the money will stay in the state of Maryland, and it goes for research, education, advocacy, education, awareness, and prevention. So all the trainings that we provide throughout the county are free. There's no charge. We can provide you with brochures, pamphlets. You know, we have a lot of literature that we can provide for you. We can go into the schools, if it's ever allowed, with presentations. We have a More Than Sad, which is for, you know, school-aged children, so they can help each other. There's just so many things that we can do to help people understand that there's help out there for them.
Where do you find are some of the targeted locations? You mentioned schools. Are there other places that you think outreach can, you know, be more beneficial than others, or?
We will do them anywhere and everywhere. The health department's had a few trainings. I think they try to do one every other month. Fire departments, first responders. We were scheduled to do one right before the pandemic, but we've already done, I believe, two at Winfield Fire Hall, which have pretty good turnouts. Churches want their youth organizations involved. It's anybody that wants to do a training, we are more than happy to do. We'll go into your business. We will do whatever we can.
When you say we, whose we? Is it your husband and you, or is it?
There's volunteers all over the state that have been trained Talk Save Lives providers. So it depends on the area.
Right.
Typically, Carroll County there's three of us.
Okay.
So typically it would be one of the three of us that do it, which is me and my husband, and then actually a good friend of mine.
You said an acronym earlier and began with an A, and it was four letters.
It's the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. So it's the AFSP.
And is your organization a part of AFSP?
Yeah, the AFSP holds Out of the Darkness Walks all across the country.
Okay. Is suicide prevention, was I correct in saying that it's the month of September?
Yes.
Or is it a specific day?
World Suicide Prevention Day is September 10th.
Okay.
But the entire month of September is Suicide Prevention Month.
What do you think are some of your goals over the next, say, year? You know, and it's tough because we're in this challenging time, you know, where we're battling, you know, and as I said earlier, getting together, you know, to getting the word out, and it can be pretty difficult. So what are some of your goals and ideas over this next year?
I think our goals are always the same, and it's to help, to be there, to support the county, to provide the trainings, to be there for people when they, you know, have lost someone. I have become friends with so many families through the walk, who have lost a child or lost a parent, and it's a bond like no other. You know, we can call each other at any time. So I just think it's being there and just letting people know that there is hope, there is help.
What can I do to help you? What can the county do? What can I as a commissioner, what can we as a community do to help the three of you meet those goals?
Honestly, Carroll County has been amazing in the past couple of years for us. I don't know if you know, but the health department started a suicide coalition that is now going on. So we were meeting every other month, and we had lots of plans, but obviously that all had to stop. And one of your commissioners was at the luminary ceremony Saturday night. We saw him. So Carroll County has actually been amazing with their support so far. And I would just say, continue to support us, continue to provide the trainings for the county, and help us spread the word that it's out there and there is help.
Yeah, and again, you know, I reflect on when I was in command, when I had to deal with it from a community, and I threw out a number, but the fact is, it's not about numbers, it's not about statistics, you know, it's about an individual, and it's about right. a family and a community and my neighbors. And so often we say, oh, the suicide rate is declining, or drug, you know, situations are declining or inclining. It's not about the numbers or the statistics. And especially the way you were describing Carroll County, because that's what I like about it. You know, it's not about, I always say it's not about constituents, it's about communities and neighbors and friends and family. So I really appreciate you having this conversation. It's tough, you know, and even though there shouldn't be a stigma associated with suicide, there is, you know.
Yes.
And I think that's also unfortunate, that because it's very different, you know, in every situation. I appreciate you telling your story. I appreciate your commitment to the community with the other two. I learned a lot in a very short amount of time talking with you. I did a little bit of my homework, reading some of the articles, learned a little bit about you. You're a rock star in my book, trust me. And
thank you.
I mean, the work you're doing just in the midst of a challenging time of COVID-19 and still organizing the event in Kringle Park is awesome. And sure we're going to get past that 900 once we can get ourselves back
Absolutely.
Together.
Absolutely. Yep.
And, we're going to go far from there. You know, just in the next few seconds, 30 seconds, what's on your mind to close this out?
Honestly, I'm just thankful for Carroll County supporting us through it all. It was a very, very difficult year. I was trying to figure out what to do. And the last 2 weeks, my phone, email has just been nothing but supportive and helpful. And what can we do? And honestly, Carroll County is a county that comes together when we need something. And they definitely provided for us this year when we needed help with getting things together. Parks yeah. and Rec, even the commissioners, you guys proclaimed, you had a proclamation that, September Suicide Prevention Month. Everything comes together. And I will say, you know, I have a Maryland director who's above me, and she is always in awe when she comes down here. She's like, it's so different down here in Carroll County, because she lives in Annapolis. It's a big, you know, a big area. And she's like, everybody knows everybody and everybody's so nice and everybody does whatever you need them to do. And I'm like, that's why I live here. It's correct. It is the best. So,
you know, I can't end it with anything better than that. That was pretty powerful. So let me let it go with that. Again, this is Commissioner Ed Rothstein, wishing everybody continue to stay safe and stay healthy. And we will get through this together. And as always, life is good. Thanks.